Hey, I was brief shuffling, and I'm supposed to do a reading. What does Aquarius need to know? And that's what was going through my head as I was pre-shuffling before, you know, turning on the camera, and this card flew out. So, what does Aquarius need to know? Or something Aquarius needs to know? What do Aquarians need 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 to know? There's a whole lot of love for two people, but it's as if it's unspoken. It's like it's shown, but unspoken. Because I'm seeing how his mouth is shut, and I'm drawn to that. It's unspoken words. There is a lot of communication. And it feels like both people are working on it, and they're working towards this. But this part is felt, but unspoken. What do Aquarians need to know? What do Aquarians need to know? Somebody's taking on the Queen of Pentacles energy. Very loving energy, caring. We're wanting this Ace of Pentacles. Now we've got the Tower. Okay, someone out there, they feel like things are falling apart. Now, it feels like this is a, these people are committed to one another, but someone is, it's like showing affection, but not saying, not speaking. And someone is feeling like it's falling apart. You know, it feels like they want this new beginning, this happily ever after. You know, this is one of our people. They want this abundance and just new beginning all the way around. They want the whole deal. But they feel like things are falling apart. Okay. Someone is scared. They are scared. Strength is here for them because they have that strength within them. You know, it's like they're working on this. They're working on this seed that's been planted. They're tending it. But they're all in their head. They're holding tightly to their person. They're scared to death that this person's going to walk away. Going to walk away. You know, this is leaving them kind of hanging. They're scared of that. They're scared of being left. Left out in the cold. There is a need for these two people to be truthful with one another. And truthful with themselves. And someone's being given, you know, they're at this crossroads of deciding, it feels like, about the emotion part. You know, because it feels like we're at that point where it's time to decide. Whoever this is, they're making a decision because they feel like things are going to fall apart. And they're afraid, though. They're scared to death that if they, it's like if they open up that part of themselves, this has to do with old belief. This has to do with the old ways of other relationships. You know, it's like if they give that part of themselves, then automatically this person is going to leave them. Because this is something that happened in the past. You know, in past relationships, it's like they're scared. You know, but it feels like, you know, this feels like a blessing. And it feels like this person sees it that way, but they're having trouble. They're having trouble. They're having trouble with the love part of it. The emotional part of it. The giving of emotion part of it. It feels like they see their person. They're watching their person. They see that they could grow with their person. They're communicating with their person. But it's like they've got this war inside their head. It's like, yeah, it's like fussing with themselves about, you know, how do I bring balance to this? How do I balance this out? You know, can we stay balanced? Can we have equal give and take if, you know, someone gives their all, their love, their everything to go forward? Because this is how they're seeing their person. And it feels like they just don't know whether they can be enough. I mean, it's a feeling like, are they enough? Do they, you know, they're being told to follow their intuition because it feels like they're being guided. Now, you have to put yourself where you belong, cross watchers. The same goes for you. Okay, yes. See, there's this desire for a victory in this connection. It feels like a very strong connection. Possible soulmates. If you don't believe in that, it's just strong magnetic, you know, connection. And this does feel romantic. Someone's being guided. They may not be seeing the signs. They're scared to death because they keep looking at the past, what the past done to them. But it feels like they want to take this leap. They want this new beginning, but they have to step away from the past. They're going to have to stop looking at the past. The past is just going to keep them in the same place they are, and it feels like that's not where they want to be. It doesn't feel like they want to grow old alone. It feels like they want this connection. Because this person makes them happy. And that's the yes card. If you have a question, that's the yes card. Let's see. Okay, this card is reversed. Seven of Swords. This is confusion. You know, someone's having, it's like they're really confused. They're confused. That's exactly what this is. It's confusion. You know, they're all in their head, but they're confused. They're constantly in their head. Eight of Swords. Someone that's causing them to be anxious and feel conflicted. But it's a feeling that they want to work on this. They want to keep working on growing this connection. They want complete balance. And something's ending for someone. There's something that has to end. For some of you, you know, for this person, I feel like it's dealing with the past and healing. And that's going to balance them. And, you know, that's going to end, and then they can have this new beginning. It feels like that's what you're dealing with right now. For some of you, this could end. This connection. Eight of Pentacles, Page of Wands, Ten of Pentacles, Page of Pentacles. Okay, for many of you, this person is, they are working on healing themselves. They are working on healing themselves. They are finding balance within themselves. And that's something that they a way of thinking, and it's ending. Something is ending, and they want this new beginning. Because we got the Eight of Pentacles here, you know, and this is putting in hard work. This is, you know, effort. Someone, you know, they can see. It feels like that you and them could have stability together. This Ten of Pentacles, you know. It's like they see, they're looking, you know, with the World card, it feels like they're looking onward at what could be. And they feel like this could be a very bright, you know, future together, basically. Page of Wands. What I'm feeling, I'm feeling like this is a love connection. This is someone, this is a lover. I'm getting that strong. I'm feeling faithfulness. This is committed. This is committed in some way. There's some form of commitment. It feels like messages, a lot of messaging. But I'm also getting direct. It's like this person is very direct with their speaking. Yes. There's a sense of loyalty, reliability also. And I'm getting that this person wants a new beginning. You know, they want this... They feel like they could be very prosperous with you. They feel like you and them could be very prosperous together with the Ten of Pentacles. And you know, we got the Page of Pentacles here, and it feels like, you know, that they're holding on to you. It's like they're holding on to this connection, this relationship, this commitment, whichever. It does feel like it's a commitment, though. They're holding on to it tightly. And, you know, it feels like there is going to be, you know, messages. There's going to be talking, communicating that gives I'm getting little messages of information. In other words, there'll be things in what they say that you need to look for that can, if you're having any doubts about this because of the love not being spoken, it's like you need to be looking in their words. Because it's like, that's what I'm getting. That's all I can tell you. Yes, that's what I'm getting. As well as their actions. You know, this person, they see that you and them, there's a feeling that they see a potential, you know, for material gain. If you know, it's like they see this as very abundant connection to go, you know, to go forth with. For Aquarius. Whew, they're giving them to us for Aquarius. Anymore. For Aquarius. Anymore. For Aquarius. Anymore. Okay. Someone watches someone struggle. Too, I might add. Okay. Someone feels like this connection, this commitment is a blessing. It's what there's a feeling that this is someone's wish that they've always wanted. And yes, there is love here. Then we've got the Nine of Wands. And it feels like, with this card, you know, it feels like someone's ready. And it's like they've found their strength. They're finding their strength, yes. They are finding their strength within them. And it's like this person has a lot of knowledge. And they see the reward. I'm also getting that this person could be just a tad bit pessimistic. Yes. That's what I'm getting. Then we have the Five of Cups. And what I'm getting with this card is I'm getting someone has regrets. And they also feel bitterness. This has to do with the past. You know, it causes them to feel sorrow, it feels like, and frustrated. Because they're looking at the past. There's, you know, that need to let that go. We talked about up here. And it feels like does feel like they're coming out of that. Yeah, they are, because our next card is the Six of Swords. You know, it feels like they're moving away from that energy. It's like this person's gained insight from within. and it's like they're finding, you know, they're finding those answers to the problems, or like they're able to resolve difficulties, you know, that they've been having, and they're finding their peace, calm within thoughts, it feels like. It's they're finding their peace of mind. And then we had Temperance. It feels like they're letting a higher power help them to do so. It's really beautiful. A higher power is helping them to let go of this past way of thinking because of past hurts. Does Aquarius need to know? Do Aquarians need to know anything else? Do Aquarians need to know anything else? King of Pentacles. Three of Swords. Okay. They're being guided away from what hurt them. That's what I'm getting from that. This is what they want. They want the Two of Cups ultimately, but it's just hard for this person. It's very hard. It feels like once they get to this spot, they're coming in quickly. Because they see their person's worth and value, and I've been seeing this full and been drawn to it. They see their person as an empress. They see their person as someone who is standing tall, and it's almost as if they feel like if they don't, they're going to lose this person. That's what the feeling is. Someone feels like they'll lose their person. So, moving quicker, it feels like, once they hit that spot of healing themselves. Now, that can take time. You have to remember that. But this person, it's like they see you. They see you. They want a new beginning. They want to take this leap with you. Do we need any more? 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 Yeah, that's what they ultimately want to do because that's what they ultimately feel. But they're just scared. You know, this is here because I feel like, you know, things have to be cut out of people's lives. And I feel like also this is a higher power that's stepping in and helping this person to cut things out of their life so that they can ultimately, let's see, they're showing us, give this love, this cup, their cup, you know, their truth. Their feelings. They can give their feelings to this person that they love. You know, it's like they always say the truth sets you free. See, it's like this person's been overburdened. They've been overburdened, you know. And then we got the Five of Swords here. They've been overburdened. But, you know, this, what I'm getting with this card is healing. And I am getting commitment with this card as well. But I'm getting healing, for a sense of freedom, change. And I'm feeling, yes, this is a strong connection, magnetic. See, we got the world again. We've got the world again. Something ending, something beginning. it's like someone couldn't see clearly about their person because they have to get through their own, they have to see through what's going on with them and heal that before they can actually see the person for the way they should be seeing them, it feels like. It's that kind of type of feeling. Yeah. See, we've got the Queen of Wands here, and I feel like this, for me, I'm drawn to that sun. You know, I'm drawn to the sun. I'm drawn to, this person makes them very happy, you know. This person's glowing. Their person's glowing and makes them happy. I'm feeling energy again. I'm getting that, yes. I'm getting loyalty, you know. And it's like there's a feeling of someone's finding their purpose in life. There's inner strength. This card is here to, you know, it's about, feels like purpose in life, inner, you know, wisdom. Yeah. Generosity between the two. And then we got the Four of Wands here. You know, with this Four of Wands, well, as you can see, that's 11-11. But what I'm feeling like this is, you know, I'm getting romance. I'm getting peace. These two, it feels like they feel peace together. It's peaceful. It's just someone has these, it's like someone wants more emotion than the other's giving or something. You know, this has the potential, it feels like, to grow into more. You know, into more. It really does. You know, that's like, this card can be about weddings. Doesn't mean it's going to be, but it has the potential to be more. Eight of Wands. Okay, what I'm getting about this card right here is I'm getting that someone is going to want to communicate swiftly. Because, you know, it's like they want progress. They're going to take action. Once they reach this point and they heal themselves, they're going to take action. Because we got the Eight of Cups next. And, you know, it's like there's a fear that they could lose their person. They don't want to lose their person. There's that fear. You know, because then we had the Four of Pentacles, and it feels like they hold dearly on to this person's energy. They are. This person's, this connection, they're holding on to it. And they feel like it, you know, they've been guarding their heart, but that they're letting that guard down once they reach this healing point. But they have to reach that point, so it could take a hot minute. So you may, you know, whomever this reading's going to be for may have to find some patience. If not, then, you know, they may have to walk away. What do Aquarians need to know? 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 Oh my goodness. Keep an open mind. Your soulmate may differ from your usual type and expectations. Let go of control issues. Allow this situation to unfold naturally. What did I say? You're going to have patience. Soulmate. Yes, this is your soulmate. What do Aquarians need to know? What do Aquarians need to know? Make the effort. Great love is worth taking the steps you are guided to take. Feels like there's more, though. The bottom one. Worth waiting for. Divine timing is at work in your love life. What do Aquarians need to know? What do Aquarians need to know? What do Aquarians need to know? Can we have another, please? I feel like another, please. I feel like there's another, please. One more, please. Okay, we got two, it looks like. Playfulness. To recapture romance, allow your inner youthful spirit of fun to shine. Honeymoon. Enjoy the bliss of holiday time together. It doesn't mean honeymoon, but it could be honeymoon for some of you. For others of you, it is like, you know, taking some time together with one another. Yeah. Build this, yeah, this relationship, it feels like. In our committed connection into a strong relationship, it feels like. Whichever way it resonates with you. Only take away what resonates. Leave the rest behind. And do give it a thumbs up. That way YouTube moves along. Have an awesome, awesome day. Bye.